Good morning, Hiland. My name is Michael Miller.
And my name is Brady Slaybaugh.
And you're watching this year's first edition of Inside the Nest. Man, what a summer it was, Brady.
You got that right, Mike. What was your favorite part?
Definitely has to be playing basketball as a senior now. What about you?
Yeah, that's fun. I cannot wait for this season. I also liked the trip our youth group took to convention in Kansas City this summer.
Yeah, that was fun. Our first story today has to do with the new classes being offered at Hiland this year.
With the retirement of Mrs. Design from last year, we have brought in some new computer classes.
With more on that, we turn it over to Lauren Hirschberger with the scoop.
This year has been exciting for many people. One of the most exciting things for me are the computer science classes. The computer science classes are taught by Mr. Kahn, who I got the privilege to interview. There are currently three classes available for high schoolers to take: web design, game design, and computer programming.
Yeah, so web design, you are coming into the class. Most people don't have much knowledge of web design, so we learn the basic web design language, which is HTML, and we also learn styling of websites, which is called CSS, and we kind of take it slow and we go through the steps to learn how to create web pages, not only how to create web pages, but how would we apply that to a business or to your personal web page, where are they stored, how does the internet actually find these web pages, that type of thing. So the whole class is geared towards giving you enough knowledge to create your own web page and hopefully make it an interactive web page as well.
So what do you think about game design?
So game design, that's where you learn kind of foundational computer programming concepts. And then you use those to start creating games. I like to make it kind of a fun interactive class where we jump in right away to creating games. And we do a lot of that with Scratch programming, which is a language created by MIT. And that's been going really well this year so far. And we'll continue to progress into kind of more advanced gaming concepts and hopefully continue to create just bigger and better games for the class as we move forward.
And what do you think about computer programming then?
So computer programming is kind of the more system-based class. We talk about how to communicate with the computer using specific programming languages. The first one we start with is called Python, and we learn the proper syntax to use and how to tell the computer what we want it to do. And then we look at the applications of the actual programming, because, for example, I think it's Google that runs on the Python language. So there are a lot of different things you can do with that. So first we learn kind of vocabulary we use to talk to the computer, then learn how can we use that to make it do what we want it to do.
Okay, and where do you see these classes going in the future then?
In the future, oh man, there's a lot of different ways that I'd like to see it go, but hopefully continue to even branch out further, maybe in like a mobile applications direction where you can make mobile apps for, you know, tablets or cell phones, that type of thing, and maybe even just having some more advanced classes for those students that find an interest in one of the foundational classes. Maybe they would like to learn even more advanced concepts in the future and that type of thing. I could see it going in that direction.
Okay, is there anything else you would like to talk about?
Oh man, well, I think you should all take my classes because they're really fun. And you're in my classes, are they fun?
Yes, a lot of fun.
All right, a lot of fun. We learn a lot of good stuff. We have a good time in here, but we also learn a lot. So, yeah, I think that's it.
Thank you, Mr. Kahn. The computer classes sound like they're going to be a lot of fun in the future. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Lauren. I can't wait to see how that goes.
So, Brady, do you think we should tell the people why we're here?
You know, I just think we might.
Well, we're here to inform the people that the fall play is coming up soon.
That's right, Mike. This year's play is called Bad Seeds.
With more on that, we'll turn the story over to Damon Hoseller and Peyton Anderson.
This year's fall play will be a thriller. Fitting, seeing how it'll be performed on Halloween weekend. Though this isn't your typical spooky showing. Instead, the play is about a normal family dealing with an unsuspecting killer. We decided to ask Ms. Slaybaugh about her decisions about the play and what she expected from it.
So what made you decide to direct a serious play this year as opposed to the comedies that you usually put on?
The comedies have always been really a lot of fun, and I've really enjoyed doing comedies. I really like directing comedy, and I know the kids like being in it, and people like coming to see it. But since we've started the theater class here, I have decided that I would really like to do some things that stretch our students in their acting abilities and stuff like that. And And so I decided this year to do a serious play for that reason. Another reason that I did it is because the show is Halloween weekend, and I thought it would be fun to do something a little more on the psychological thriller side. So that is another reason why I chose to do a serious play this year.
So what's the hardest part about directing a play like Bad Seed?
One of the hardest parts about directing a play like Bad Seed is that some of the characters, for instance, Rachel Reber plays a bereaved woman who has lost her child, and she is coping with it by drinking a lot. And one of the hardest things is guiding her in such a way that the character doesn't become like a funny drunk. Last year, Rachel actually played a funny drunk in You Can't Take It With You, but like guiding actors in a play like this to make their character have several dimensions and depth rather than just like one dimensional, oh, this character is always evil or this character is always drunk, and keeping them from making them funny is something that I'm finding to be a challenge. Also, another thing is that the majority of the action, like you never see a dead body on stage. You never see anybody kill anybody else or anything like that. It all happens off stage. And so there's not a lot of action in the play. And so keeping things interesting through movement and vocal inflection and things like that is also proving to be more of a challenge than what I thought. It's just a lot more intricate and complicated than I expected. But the kids are definitely up to the challenge.
We also decided to ask the actors what they thought about being in the play.
So what are your thoughts on being in a play like Bad Seed?
Well, I am glad we're doing a serious play. I mean, it's different, and I think it's an experience that we're not going to forget anytime soon, so I'm really looking forward to it.
All right, Rachel, so what do you think about doing a thriller like Bad Seed instead of doing a comedy like we usually do every year?
Well, personally, I really like comedies, but I'm super excited this year for the thriller because it's going to be amazing.
I think doing a thriller this year instead of the comedy is going to be a little tougher. We have to convey that fear in people instead of just like entertaining them. But I'm up for the challenge, and I think it'll be really fun.
Damon, you've been going around asking everyone about this play and their thoughts on it, but no one's been around to ask you. So here I am. Damon, what are your thoughts on Bad Seed being a drama rather than the usual comedy?
Well, personally, I'm better at doing comedies myself, and I find them more enjoyable to do. But I think it is very important that we do a serious comedy. It tests what the actors can do, and it's very interesting to do. And I think that it has potential to change one step at a time what the plays at Hiland can do every year. Again, Bad Seed will be premiering on Halloween weekend. Back to you guys.
Thanks, guys. I will definitely be there for that.
And make sure for those of you that are going to use the hashtag #BadSeedsOfHHS.
Now, our next story comes to us from two of the greatest guys we know.
Their intellectual abilities exceed far more than most earthly possibilities.
With our back-to-school story, take it away, Michael and Brady.
Kane is in the building.
With the new school year coming into full swing, Brady Schlabaugh and I decided to ask the students and faculty the always looming question. So Scott, what are you looking forward to most this year?
Basketball.
The school year to end.
I'm looking forward to playing all the sports.
The last day of school.
Hanging with friends.
Beating Garaway at basketball again.
Chris Klein in study hall.
The Buckeyes football season.
Seeing old friends again.
The boys basketball games.
Having study hall with Mr. Shaw.
Day 184.
Friends.
Getting to know the new students of mine that I've never had in class before.
Getting it over with.
Basketball.
Playing golf.
I am looking forward to turning up Shaw's study hall, throwing a party.
I'm most looking forward to seeing Kennedy every day.
probably playing basketball over the winter.
Going to Wayndale football games.
I don't know.
Getting a giant cookie at the end of the year because I'm a senior.
What are you looking forward to most about this school year, aside from Megan Beachy not being here?
So, Holly, what are you looking forward to most this school year?
To my retirement.
We're going to miss you, Holly.
Tell me, what does it look like in heaven?
Holly will be retiring on March 1st. Make sure the next time you see Holly that you thank her for her 25 years in willing service to the school district.
Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away?
Thanks to us for that great story about coming back to school.
But more importantly, we're here with Holly because not many of you knew about her retirement.
So we thought she should help us sign off the show. I'm Brady Slaybaugh.
I'm Michael Miller.
And I'm Holly Troyer.
And thank you for watching Inside the Nest.